There's this moment in soccer that's such high stakes. It's called a penalty kick.
He's an expert penalty taker, but when the pressure is on and the nerves jangle.
The ball is placed in the center of the box, 12 yards from goal. It's just me and the kicker. When the ball is shot, I have to predict where the ball is going. Will they kick it to the bottom right corner, the top left corner, or straight down the middle? And on average, keepers have just a 30% chance of stopping the ball. But if I can improve my reaction time by just a second or two, I may have a better chance to win the game.
Eye-tracking technology is helping goalies gain the edge over their competition. And it's revealing something about the brain we never knew before. Keep your eye on the ball. Anyone who has played sports has heard that over and over, because tracking the pass, puck, rebound, or shot is key to completing that action. When you lose focus, you make mistakes. So athletes are turning to eye-tracking technology to understand how to improve their focus, because even the slightest improvements in reaction can be the difference between being a hero and being a zero.
So eye tracking is literally tracking the pupil of your eye about where it is oriented in space. When you drill deeper, what you're looking at is really the behavior of the eye.
For any movement in sports, you need to send information to the brain about what to do and where to go. Your eyes gather that information. So if they can focus on the one thing that matters, it's easier to react and decide where to move. This tech works by using a near-infrared light camera trained on your pupil's movements and overlays on video that captures what you're focused on and for how long. It's pretty simple, but analyzing that and applying it to your game can be more challenging. For example, this heat map shows where a player's eyes are focused the most. It should be on the ball, but oftentimes it's looking down the field or to the sidelines. So watching back where you're looking and for how long can help a player train their gaze better. So practice makes perfect.
What we think is that you can get ahead of that by training the eye as you're gaining that skill. What we've done at Fixation is find a new way to apply it. When I was 16, I was blinded in my left eye as a goalkeeper. I was in a walkthrough practice. I wish it was like a better story, but really it's just this freak accident, and it can't process the light coming into the brain as my right eye does. And I was from there on very interested in how the eyes gather information for the brain and then use it during sports.
The science behind the tech shows that it likely does improve how athletes play the game. Research published in 2012 says, although eye tracking in sports is typically thought to improve the physical game of an athlete, it actually reveals more about the cognitive thinking and psychology of an athlete. Researchers found that eye movement is an involuntary action that's based on reaction. So tracking eye movement can directly measure the cognitive thought process in real time. Understanding that flow of information from the eyes to the brain and back again is helping athletes have a better insight into how their brain works and control actions, like gaze, when they have just fractions of a second for a make or break decision.
Feel okay?
I'm Ken Marquis. I am a professional goalkeeper, and right now I'm in New Jersey to like train and coach a little bit on the side. Using the eye tracking as a goalkeeper really helpful because it'll help you learn how to find the ball faster. And the faster you can do that, the more efficiently you can move and try and hopefully make that save.
And so what you'll notice you're doing?
It's a compelling case. So I wanted to try it out myself. In full transparency, I'm not a soccer player.
I can't touch my toes.
So I strapped in to find out if it could tell me how bad I am.
So this is right where you're looking. These are your eyes.
John had me start off with a toss catch drill, just to get used to the system.
Then, cool, I can do that.
Then came the real training. This heat map is showing that I really am not focused on the right thing. And not surprisingly, my gaze is all over the place.
So what it's saying is, over all of your sequences, you see how much dispersion there is? Mm-hmm. Your eyes, even though you're trying to look at the ball, are still darting around.
Okay, but, so I'm not doing it right.
Well, it shows that you're a novice.
Time to put what I learned to the test.
Ooh.
Oh,
turns out my results in this limited test didn't change much. John says and the real benefit is using it over and over again in practice, which is why it helps professional players like Kaylin.
Anytime you're called in to touch the ball is usually a make or break moment. The pressure of being a goalkeeper is something I really enjoy.
Eye tracking, it's something that, one, separates you from the pack, because it's not very common right now. You have so many people that are looking for the thing that's going to take them to the next level. And with gaze behavior, something not only is it so simple, but at the same time, it's not well practiced, it's not well coached, and we want to solve that problem.
Thanks for watching our series, The Edge. If you want to find out more about how technology is changing the game, go to our website and subscribe to Freethink for more videos like this one every week.